how to build a jetpack.
You've seen it on Boba Fett, you've seen it on the Rocketeer. It's the jetpack, the holy grail of futuristic transportation.
The idea of just being able to strap on a pack and fly anywhere you want to go, how about that for beating traffic?
Today, you will be building a JB9 jetpack, the only true jetpack in operation in the world.
I thought this was not a thing that had been properly invented yet. This exists.
You will need two jet turbine engines, throttle and steering hand controls, a kerosene fuel tank, a carbon fiber molded harness, and a hatred of sitting in traffic. Let's get started. Step one, necessity is the mother of invention. So first, become fed up with existing personal flight technology.
In the past, jetpacks were more like rocket packs, and they used a lot of very heavy and very expensive fuel, and they could run out of this fuel in as short as 30 seconds. And it wasn't really good for anything besides maybe a demonstration at the Olympics or an appearance in a James Bond film.
If you want to fly like this for more than 30 seconds, you need to find a way to generate downward thrust for a longer period of time. Step two, develop the perfect size turbine engine.
We've got a lot of different size engines. There's huge jet engines to power big 747s and small ones for little hobby applications. What we need for a jetpack is one just exactly right size to carry the weight of a human.
The thrust you generate has to be enough to counteract the weight of your pilot, the weight of the jetpack, and the fuel. We recommend building two jet engines with turbine blades made of high-performance alloys. Your engine should run on kerosene and produce 210 pounds of thrust each while operating at 70,000 RPMs or higher. Step three, design a way to keep yourself safely attached to your jetpack. Construct a harness from state-of-the-art carbon fiber, attaching nylon straps, aluminum buckles, and a layer of foam for comfort.
You want to minimize weight on your jetpack system because you only have so much fuel. The more mass you have, the more fuel you need for the thrust to come out so that you can propel yourself.
With your harness complete, connect your 10-gallon carbon fiber fuel tank to the back of the harness. 10 gallons of fuel will provide 10 minutes of flight time. Be sure to time your flight so you'll know how long you have before your fuel runs out. Step four, it's time to attach all your components together. Construct two handles with arms, A, out of lightweight aluminum, and connect to both engines, B, via 2-inch aluminum tubes. Connect your engine and arms to your harness with a rod end, placed just behind the neck of the harness.
A rod end is a joint that can articulate in any direction. It's sort of like your shoulder. You have a ball and you have a socket that goes on top of it, and the socket can move in any direction you need.
Step five, now all you need is the ability to control your pack. Add a throttle control on the right-hand grip to feed more fuel to your engines.
The throttle handle is used to control the thrust coming out of the jets.
You go faster or higher when you turn the handle or throttle forward.
But if something happens, you turn it back, it will slow you down.
Add steering controls to the left-hand grip.
How are we going to control our jetpack? Well, we're going to use these really coolly named things called jetivators. For our jetpack, when you turn the handle, it's going to change the orientation of these jetivators.
It's going to be controlling via a cable a set of vents that will move left and right in order to be able to cause you to change direction.
A jetivator is a rudder to air, what a ship rudder is to water. If you even look inside your own car at your air conditioning vents, those things that change the direction of air, that's what our jetivators are gonna essentially be. But in our case, the air is moving so quickly that it can actually move the whole jetpack. Jetivators, I love that word.
You now have the ability to completely control your jetpack.
So you use your controller to change your orientation.
You can move forward or back. This is called pitch, and it basically changes how fast or slowly you're going.
Yaw is when your body turns in this direction.
You can also move the handle to the right and to the left, and this is roll, like you're starting a cartwheel.
Step six, add a fuel tank and you'll be ready to soar.
We're making the tank out of carbon fiber because it has the benefit of being both very light and very strong, but the problem for something like a jetpack is that it's kind of brittle, it can crack.
You're basically strapped to a whole set of fuel. The last thing you want to do is have something go wrong and catch fire.
Your jetpack runs on kerosene, which is highly combustible. Therefore, it is crucial to handle your fuel tank with care.
So for safety, let's also include a rubber bladder inside of this carbon fiber fuel tank so that if it does crack, you still have that added safety of the rubber.